On the morning of 13th of June 1944, during the fierce battles in Normandy, SS-Obersturmführer Wittmann and the crew of his heavy Tiger tank were standing ready for action. They were about to take part in one of the most famous tank actions in military history. Wittmann had left his company to reconnoiter the battlefield when he became aware of the presence of an entire British armored battalion halted on the road nearby. Undaunted, Wittmann drove his single Tiger at the column, firing on the move. The Tiger gained the element of surprise and quickly destroyed 12 half-tracks, 3 light tanks, and 6 medium tanks.
One of the most striking examples, of course, not so much of tank warfare, but of the handling of an individual tank, indeed what it could do and its capability, was demonstrated in 1944 by Hauptmann Wittmann in his Tiger tank. Here you've got an accomplished tank commander, which he clearly was, with perhaps an expert eye for the tactical situation. And I think it's probably a record in maybe in tank warfare history that he was able, with one tank, to disable what was virtually a British tank column.
Wittmann calmly departed the scene of carnage to report, rearm, and gather reinforcements. 2 hours later, he returned to battle. This time, he destroyed a further 12 medium tanks, 4 heavy tanks, and 14 Bren gun carriers. All in a day's work for the most successful tank commander in history.
Michael Wittmann was really probably the most successful junior tank commander of the entire Second World War. Not only did he achieve an unprecedentedly high kill rate, 138 tanks, 132 anti-tank guns, but he was also the recipient of some of Nazi Germany's highest awards, for example, the Knight's Cross with Oak Leaves and Swords, which was effectively the German equivalent of the Victoria Cross. So in sheer statistical terms, he was an extremely successful commander. He was also an extremely competent leader, an inspirational leader, one might say. And this, I think, leads on to something else which is also important, which is Michael Wittmann's propaganda value to the Nazi propaganda machine. It wasn't simply a question of what he did on the battlefield. It was his influence and his inspiration to other German fighting men and to the factory workers who produced the Tiger tanks with which Wittmann achieved most of his victories, that was also particularly important. So regardless of what one thinks of his political viewpoint, and of course he was a dedicated National Socialist, in sheer military terms at the tactical level, and in terms of his psychological impact, both upon Germans and indeed upon the Allies, his impact was immense.
Michael Wittmann was born in the tiny village of Vogeltal in the Upper Pfalz on the 22nd of April 1914. He was the first son of a farmer, Johann Wittmann, and his wife Ursula. In 1934, at the age of 21, Wittmann joined the German army, signing up for a 2-year tour. In the first days of the Nazi regime, compulsory military service had not yet been reintroduced, so Wittmann was a volunteer when he reported for military service in Freising with the 19th Infantry Regiment. As a small standing army, comprised exclusively of volunteers, the interwar Reichswehr was a high-quality force which expected very high standards. Wittmann met those exacting standards, and after 1 year in the service, he was promoted to Gefreiter on the 1st of November, 1935. 1936 was the halcyon period for the Nazi Party in Germany. The first flushes of economic successes for Hitler's National Socialists impressed the young Wittmann. In the closed world of the military, the fervent Nazi beliefs of many of his colleagues also made an impression. Many of his colleagues planned to join the newly formed Waffen SS, and Wittmann decided that he too would join the military wing of the Nazi Party after his own army service. On the 1st of November, 1936, Wittmann applied for admission to the SS and was accepted into what was to become one of the most notorious organizations in history.
The Waffen SS, or armed SS, was essentially the regular armed forces or ideological spearhead of the National Socialist cause, composed, at least in its early stages, of racially pure, ideologically utterly committed and extremely physically fit young men. It eventually grew to a strength by 1945 of almost 1 million personnel and provided something like 40 combat divisions for the German armed forces.
The Waffen SS actually stands for armed SS, so that they are specifically fighting soldiers. And they were unusual in that they were very innovative in their tactics and also things like their dress. They were some of the first troops to use camouflage clothing.
In the case of many exceptional German soldiers, such as Field Marshal Erwin Rommel, revisionists have subsequently tried to play down the enthusiasm they held for Hitler and all he stood for. This is not true of Michael Wittmann. In his case, there was to be no redeeming conversion or late change of allegiance. He was a simple man, and the seductive allure of the Nazi Party drew his unquestioning obedience. Sadly, he was never to swerve from that evil path. Wittmann was given the SS number 311623 and proved to be a model National Socialist. In his free time, he participated in sports, recruiting, and took part in the mass political demonstrations and rallies of the period. In contrast to the frantic world of mass political rallies, Wittmann's first SS military posting was less than glamorous. He was employed as a guard at the large Wehrmacht munitions dump. Wittmann was soon bored with his routine. He wanted to be near the center of this new force in Germany, so he applied to join the SS Liebstandarte, Adolf Hitler's personal bodyguard. Already, this was the best known and most elite unit in the Third Reich.
The Liebstandarte Adolf Hitler might reasonably be described as Hitler's Praetorian Guard. Formed in 1933 as a bodyguard for the Führer personally, it later expanded as the military vanguard of National Socialism, if you like, and in 1943 eventually became a fully fledged Panzer division of the Waffen SS with a strength of about 20,000 men. Both as a division and earlier as a regiment, it participated on the most important fronts of the Second World War, acting as an armoured spearhead for German offensive actions and as a fire brigade that was sent to collapsing sectors of the front in order to prop them up. So an absolutely elite formation.
Thanks to his rigorous military background, Wittmann met the very strict selection criteria and was accepted. He began training with his new unit on the 5th of April, 1937, at the main cadet school in Berlin-Leicherfeld. Wittmann was assigned to the 17th Company, which was an armored scout car platoon. As part of an elite formation, the men of the armored scout company received an intensive training course, which transformed them into experts. These skills were later to stand him in good stead, but for the time being, the newfound expertise was not needed. Hitler was still achieving his aims by a mixture of bluff and inspired gambles. In October 1938, Wittmann took part in the entry into the Sudetenland. The reception he witnessed as waves of excitement swept through the people made a lasting impression on him. The storm of jubilation eclipsed even the fervent National Socialist rallies which he had attended. He was awarded his first of many medals, commemorating the reunification of Austria and the Sudetenland with the German Reich. From now on, medals and decorations would occupy a special place in Wittmann's affections.